Hey, what's up, guys? It's Online Money 24/7, and today I'm going to be talking about what I wish I knew when I started Shopify dropshipping. So, first thing you got to keep in mind is nothing is super simple. It's not going to be a piece of cake. Everybody out there on YouTube or on the internet wants to tell you how easy Shopify is. Yes, it is simple to set up, and it is easy to create a store. I definitely would say that. Shopify is has a very simple interface to create a nice looking store. And that's why I use it in comparison to other e-commerce platforms. But the idea that Shopify dropshipping specifically is going to be super easy is not exactly the picture that you want to paint in your mind. It's going to take some work. And a lot of people want to tell you it's super easy out there in terms of actually succeeding with a dropshipping store, because they want you to buy their course or this and that. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's just that you have to be careful who you're buying a course from, because some of them are kind of scamming you in a way. And you just got to keep your eyes out there, because they want to sell you that everything is super simple. And while it's easy, you are creating a business, which I'll get into in a little bit here. But second, advertising. When you start a Shopify dropshipping store, most people are either going to do Facebook ads, or they're going to do some sort of Instagram type of advertising. Not specifically Instagram ads, but Instagram promotions through influencers. So the one on the left, though, Facebook ads. I blew like $250 when I first started my Shopify store back at the beginning of this year. I did not make much of a return at all. If anything, I basically kind of like lost maybe $100 out of that $250, because I did make some sales off of that. But Facebook ads are very complicated, and it takes time to test and see what actually works. It is definitely a great way to scale up in the future, but starting out, not necessarily the easiest thing to get a hold of. Whereas Instagram influencers, you can pay that money, $50 or $100, however much it is for a post. And while that is expensive, you will know right away if it worked or not. Facebook, you got to drag it on. You might be spending $5 to $10 a day. And that's how I lost so much money initially. And then I switched over to Instagram promotion through hashtags and stuff like that. And it works so much better for me. And it depends on a case-by-case basis on what your products are. But I'm just comparing the two, and that's something that I kind of wish I knew, is maybe I should just start with Instagram instead of wasting about 2 months on Facebook losing money. So that's just something to keep in mind. Going back to starting a business. When you're starting a Shopify dropshipping store, you are starting a business. And 9 out of 10 businesses fail. I know it's a cliche thing that every business fails, but it's true. A lot of businesses fail because people don't want to put in the work. The actual work to make it work and be profitable, because it sounds like super easy. Sounds like cake when everyone's talking about Shopify, and it's great. It's an awesome platform and I love it. That's why I use it. But it's not like the actual business behind it. It's going to take a lot of work to find what kind of product will work for you, who your target market will be for that product, because you have to set aside your own personal things. Like if you think, oh, I want to make a store with basketballs. I want to make a store with, oh, it's basketball stuff, and then it also has jewelry and all this. Oh, yeah, it's going to be great. You want to stick to a niche, like, and make a plan when you're starting a store. Pick a niche that you like. And focus on that, whether it's beauty, whether it's this or that, where everything's going to sell well, and compare the competition too, because there's a lot of other people trying to follow the trends. And that's the other thing, doing your research. Google Trends is actually a great tool that you can utilize. It's free, and you just go on, you just search Google Trends, and you can look at certain keywords that people are searching, and you set it to it about the past like 12 months, or I like to set it to the past 5 years, because then it's easier to see the gradual change in the use of the keyword. If it was hot during a certain time of the year, maybe a year ago, and now it's not, or something like that, you could see what's actually trending in terms of keywords. So like, I don't know, like elephant jewelry, that's a keyword right there. You could see if elephant jewelry is trending. And it doesn't necessarily have to be like 100%, like it doesn't have to rank as 100 on there, But as long as it's ranking decent, like I'd say anywhere above 50, it's usually a pretty good keyword. But that only really matters if you're trying to target a certain type of trend. Some people start stores in super niche stuff, like a penguin, hats or something. I mean, you could really do it on anything. You could do this whole thing on actually anything, as long as you find a market to sell to. So it may not be trending, but there's a lot of people that you can find during certain long-tailed niches on Instagram, doing your research, and figure out a way to market to them through either paid promotions, like through Instagram advertising, with shout-outs from influencers in that niche, and you could gain an audience that way. And so just start testing. That is the biggest thing. You may want to sell this bracelet, but there may be too many people already selling that exact same bracelet, and it's not going to work for you. So maybe you want to try a backpack. Maybe this backpack will work great for you. It all just depends on your testing, and that's something that's really important, because when I started my store, I was like, oh yeah, I'm going to sell this product, and I would hammer it down on one product, and I stuck too long on at least early on. Like, once I found the product that worked really well for me, I tried out a lot of different advertising methods, and then I found that the thing I did with Instagram worked really well. But, you know, don't get too stuck on a specific product, because you might just not have found a good winner for the market that you're trying to sell to. You know, like if you're trying to sell this wristband to someone, or bracelet, sorry. If you're trying to sell this bracelet to someone, it may be someone that would never ever want this black backpack. You just have to find the right kind of people to buy the product that you're trying to sell. And find a good product too. It has to be a good product that people actually would want. So maybe try and find another store that's selling the same thing and kind of emulate them. See what's working. That is another way you can test things. But, you know, if there's a million people already selling it, it's going to be really hard for you to come into the market and actually make sales. That's kind of what happened in my store, at least after a few months, because other people were hopping on the trend and it kind of died down a little bit. But that's just something that, you know, I made my money during that really good peak times, and then I moved on to something else. You just have to adjust with the trends, because a lot of these things, unless they're not going to last forever. Like, this whole thing's not going to last forever unless you're building a really solid business, which is what I said is you want to make a good plan, and you can adjust to the market and build up a really solid email list or a customer base. And once you have that, you know, you've got a lot of skin in the game that other people don't have, and that can definitely help you in the long run. So those are just some things that I would say definitely I wish I knew when I first started. So hopefully this helped you guys out. And if you could just click the link below, and that will take you to a free 14-day free trial for Shopify. If you want to get started, like I said, that's just link below. Be sure to subscribe, like this video. If you have any questions, leave that down in the comment section below. And I'll see you guys in the next one.